morning and welcome to this 11th Sunday after Pentecost on this August the 16th to worship at St. John's Episcopal Church. Our opening hymn this morning is hymn 390. We'll sing verses 1, 2, and 4. Praise to the Lord the Almighty. Hymn 390.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires are known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Our song of praise this morning is the Venite on S35 of the hymnal.
Come before his presence with thanksgiving and raise a loud shout to him bestow.
Almighty God, you have given your only Son to be for us a sacrifice for sin, and also an example of godly life. Give us grace to receive thankfully the fruits of his redeeming work, and to follow daily in the blessed steps of his most holy life. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Amen.
The first lesson is a reading from Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, maintain justice and do what is right. For soon my salvation will come and my deliverance be revealed. And the foreigners who join themselves to the Lord, to minister to him, to love the name of the Lord, and to be his servants, all who keep the Sabbath and do not profane it, and hold fast my covenant, these I will bring to my holy mountain and make them joyful in my house of prayer. Their burnt offerings and their sacrifices will be accepted on my altar. For my house shall be called a house of prayer for all peoples. Thus says the Lord God, who gathers the outcast of Israel, I will gather others to them besides those already gathered. The word of the Lord. The psalm appointed for today is Psalm 67, found in the Book of Common Prayer on page 675. Let's say in unison Psalm 67, verse 1 through 7. May God be merciful to us and bless us. Show us the light of his countenance and come to us. Let your ways be known upon earth, your saving help among all nations. Let the peoples praise you, O God. Let all the peoples praise you. Let the names be glad, nations be glad and sing for joy, for you judge the peoples with equity and guide all the nations upon earth. Let the peoples praise you, O God. Let all the peoples praise you. The earth has brought forth her increase. May God, our own God, give us his blessing. May God give us his blessing. And may all the ends of the earth stand in awe of him. The second lesson is a reading from Paul's letter to the Romans, chapter 11. I ask then, has God rejected his people? By no means. I myself am an Israelite, a descendant of Abraham, a member of the tribe of Benjamin. God has not rejected his people whom he foreknew. For the gifts and the calling of God are irrevocable. Just as you were once disobedient to God, but have now received mercy because of their disobedience, so they have now been disobedient in order that by the mercy shown to you, they too may now receive mercy. For God has imprisoned all in disobedience, so that he may be merciful to all. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our gospel hymn this morning is 398, beginning with verses 1 and 2.
Thank you.
Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Jesus left that place and went away to the district of Tyre and Sidon. Just then a Canaanite woman from that region came out and started shouting, "Have mercy on me, Lord, Son of David. My daughter is tormented by a demon." But he did not answer her at all. And his disciples came and urged him, saying, "Send her away, for she keeps shouting after us." He answered, "I was sent only to the lost sheep of the house of Israel." But she came and knelt before him, saying, "Lord, help me." He answered, "It is not fair to take the children's food and throw it to the dogs." She said, "Yes, Lord, yet even the dogs eat the crumbs that fall from their master's table." Then Jesus answered her, "Woman, great is your faith. Let it be done for you as you wish." And her daughter was healed instantly. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
The noise of our lives that we can hear your voice. In the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Mercy is always something we want for ourselves while often wanting justice for others. Mercy is always something we want for ourselves while often wanting justice for others. Our world is full of people seeking justice. And let's be fair, justice is very important. It's part of our Christian calling. But I think it's also important to understand God's version of justice and mercy and how to live that out in our daily lives. As we said in Psalm 67, may God be merciful to us and bless us. Show us the light of his countenance and come to us. Well, mercy in a really curious way is found in this scene in Tyre and Sidon. It's not easy to see, especially when Jesus starts off his interaction with this Canaanite woman. "I came for the lost sheep of Israel." Doesn't sound or seem very merciful or gracious at all. It seems so opposite of Jesus' previous behaviors. For in Matthew in chapter 8, Jesus was quite merciful to the Gentile, to the centurion who came to Jesus and asked him to heal his sick servant. Not only did Jesus cure the servant, but he praised the centurion, saying to him he was a man of greater faith than all the people in Israel. And Jesus' interaction this day that we read with this woman seems even stranger. When she is one of the first to call him and recognize him as the Messiah, calling him Son of David. She receives mercy, yet Jesus seems so derogatory toward her. Either Jesus is having a very bad day and was super cranky and just took it out on her, right? Or he is being playful with her. There is this tongue-in-cheek exchange that is going on between he and this woman. Maybe a little wink was in there that we couldn't see and didn't get written in the Gospels. But something is going on. Something where perhaps even, you know how a person will say something out loud, I do this as a preacher on occasion, where it might be said in the hushed circles, but when it's said out in front of the crowd, everybody understands this is ludicrous what this person is saying. Well, the unidentified woman begins her conversation with Jesus using a key word, and it's our focus for today. Have mercy on me, Lord, Son of David. She's asking for a gift of mercy, a gift that she understands that she doesn't necessarily deserve. I came across a great example, an explanation of mercy. It was a mother sought the pardon of her son from Napoleon. And the emperor said, well, it's his second offense and justice demanded his death. To which the mother responded, I don't ask for justice. I'm pleading for mercy. But, said the emperor, he does not deserve mercy. And just like the woman that was great in the story today, this mom says, sire, it would not be mercy if he deserved it. Well then, said the emperor, I will have mercy. And her son was saved. Well, we love to interpret this story, and people often do, this one of this Canaanite lady, this woman, as one that teaches that if you are persistent, you get what you ask for, right? And then I read a commentator that I really appreciated his view, because I'm not always sure that that works, but this commentator suggests that Jesus is responsive to this lady, this woman, this Canaanite woman, because he finds in her what he longs from his own people, or from all people, right? Look at the sequence. So she begins, she asks for mercy from the Messiah. He totally ignores her request, and the disciples say, send her away. She keeps shouting at us. They're frustrated. They don't know what to do. And Jesus tries to explain his denial. I've come for the lost sheep of Israel. And then at this point, I'm going to suggest to you, she becomes the definition of what Jesus is looking for in people. She asks for mercy, and yet she becomes the definition of it, both then and now. For in the midst of this rejection, she kneels down in front of Jesus, and she simply asks, Lord, help me. He keeps up his denial by giving her this food for the children of Israel, and she says, yes, but even the dogs, right, they get the crumbs, and he's not referring to him as a dog like we understand a dog as a pet, but really as a scavenger, right? That's what a dog was in her day. And she, in the Jewish way, does continue this banter, which is part of that persistence that we love. But as the commentator pointed out, how would you feel led to respond to Jesus at this point, at his disciples? They keep denying, they keep giving you these derogatory, it seems, examples. What would be coming out of your mouth towards him? Would you want to be kind, or would you want to have some choice words for him? Would you kneel down at such a denial? And the most amazing point in all this is that she shows mercy. She is the one who is actually merciful and continues to be merciful to these who don't even deserve her mercy. She is the very definition of mercy to the one from whom she seeks it. I'm telling you, there is something incredible about this lady to be able to do that. For mercy is always something we want for ourselves, while often wanting justice for others. Well, I think there's this great lesson of mercy because it is a tremendous transformer of our world. For we see mercy through the life, death, and resurrection of Jesus, this gift that we don't deserve, that transforms us. And God is calling us each and every day, be merciful as I am merciful. Be merciful to our spouses or to our family, to our children or grandchildren. Be merciful to public servants, to waiters or checkers or fast food workers, to those first responders in our world. to other political views, maybe most difficult of all, to other drivers, right? People who drive insanely in our world, but to people. For what happens in our relationships when, after offending someone, they show us mercy? When someone is merciful to us, it transforms it. Or when someone's done something against us and we show them a gift they don't deserve, mercy and love and grace, it transforms us. Remember, as Jesus said in the Beatitudes, "Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy." Let us all be merciful. Amen.
Let us say together the words of the Nicene Creed on page 358 of the Book of Common Prayer. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshiped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
The prayers of the people, Form 3, are found in the Book of Common Prayer on page 387. Father, we pray for your holy Catholic Church. Grant that every member of the Church may truly and humbly serve you, that your name may be glorified by all people. We pray for all bishops, priests, and deacons, that they may be faithful ministers of your word and sacraments. We pray for all who govern and hold authority in the nations of the world,
that there may be justice and peace on the earth.
Give us grace to do your will in all that we undertake.
Find favor in your sight.
Have compassion on those who suffer from any grief or trouble. Give to the departed eternal rest. We praise you for your saints who have entered into joy. Let us pray for our own needs and those of others.
Pray especially this day for Clark Also, Lord, we ask that you cure this world of COVID. O Lord, our God, accept the fervent prayers of your people. In the multitude of your mercies, look with compassion upon us and all who turn to you for help. For you are gracious, O lover of souls, and to you we give glory, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. And let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Peace, peace, my friends, peace. Well, again, it's a great joy to be with you. Every time I walk in here, it's a bit of a great time because I get to worship the Lord. And at the same time, I'm missing the community. And so just a reminder to me how much I miss you when we're not able to gather together. But I am thankful that you have joined us here on Facebook or YouTube or the website, whatever it may be, that you are able to worship our Lord in this manner. And I do continually give thanks that we do have this to be able to worship. If you are new, which we have been hearing from several people in the last few weeks, just encourage you to make first contact with St. John's through our website. And on the website, there is a newcomers tab. And on the newcomers under that, you can find a lot about the church and let us know that you are interested. And we, either Reverend Lucy or myself, will get in touch with you as the first form of welcome to welcome you here to the church. Just a reminder to everyone that we will be having a healing service on August the 25th here on Facebook Live. And if you have requests for those that you would like to put in there, encourage you to email the office at office@stjohns.org, and that is one of the ways, perhaps the easiest, that we can get those names. Also, a reminder, we're having a great discussion in Zoom class on becoming beloved community from the Episcopal Church, and this will be our third in our five-week series. We have a special guest today, and encourage you to come and be a part of that discussion. I can tell you, and Lucy can affirm this, that I'm having some growing edges in this and some growing experiences that are a great blessing to me. And just through the opportunity to have this discussion and watch some different videos and visit about different things. And so it's been a real blessing in my life. And so I encourage you to do the same. Also, under children and families, Cheryl has her 10 o'clock chapel on Facebook, and also wanted to announce that there are camp outreach angels available for auction. And so I encourage you, if you would like to know about that or would like to do that, you can email Cheryl at cheryl@stjohnsmb.com, and she will reserve an angel for you. All right, let us do one of the things that we're going to do next week is we will do the blessing of the backpacks. That will be next week before the students start. But one of the things that we were doing is, usually we give each student a little tag to put on their backpack that reminds us to walk in love as Christ loved us, from Ephesians, and as part of our backpack blessing. And then we have the little shoe that reminds us to walk in love. And so we're going to ask the Lord to bless these for the students and teachers and administrators who will take one of these or receive one of these. Lord, we just thank you for the mercy that you have shown us and the way that you walked in love each and every day for us when you wandered this earth, and that love continues equally to this day. We pray that you continue to fill each one of us, especially our teachers, administrators, and students with that love. And may this little tag, this little shoe, this little reminder help them to know that they are the embodiment, the image of your love, walking each and every day to schools, through their homes, through the community, in whatever ways they're able to live in the midst of this COVID world, in this pandemic, love still reigns. And so for that, we give thanks and for your blessing upon these items. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.
I'm going to say our birthday and anniversary prayer today. This week we are celebrating the birthdays of Kent, Judy, Bill, Ann, Carl, and Becky. Here's our prayer for those celebrating a birthday this week. Watch over your children, O Lord, as their days increase. Bless and guide them wherever they may be. Strengthen them when they stand. Comfort them when discouraged or sorrowful. Raise them up if they fall. And in their hearts, may your peace, which passes all understanding, abide all the days of their lives, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And we have a special anniversary celebration this week. Ripp and Sue are celebrating their 25th wedding anniversary. We give thanks for all those celebrating anniversaries this week, and give special thanks for their 25th. Yes. Grant, O God, in your compassion, that those who celebrate the anniversary of their marriage this week may grow in forgiveness, loyalty, and love, and come at last to the eternal joys which you have promised through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
Sue claims that she's shown me a lot of grace and mercy and forgiveness in those short 25 years. So thank you for that, Sue. All right, I appeal to you, brothers and sisters, by the mercies of God, to present yourself as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to God, which is your spiritual worship.
Son, they called him Jesus.
invite you this day to join me in giving thanks for all the blessings that we have been given in terms of our time, our talent, and our treasure, and this opportunity to offer up a portion of what God has given us back to God by singing the doxology. Continues on page 367 with Eucharistic Prayer B. The Lord be with you, and also with you. Lift up your hearts, we lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give God thanks and praise. It is right and good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, for by water and the Holy Spirit you have made us a new people in Jesus Christ our Lord, to show forth your glory in all the world. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. And love which you have made known to us in creation, and the calling of Israel to be your people, and your word spoken through the prophets, and above all in the word made flesh, Jesus your Son. For in these last days you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him you delivered us from evil, and made us worthy to stand before you. In him you brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. On the night before he died for us, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, according to his command, O Father, we remember his death. We proclaim his resurrection. We await his coming in glory. And we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable through him, being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, put all things in subjection under your Christ, and bring us to that heavenly country where with St. John and all your saints we may enter the everlasting heritage of your sons and daughters through Jesus Christ our Lord. the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation. By him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Hallelujah, Christ, our Passover is sacrificed for us. Therefore, let us keep the feast. Hallelujah. These are the gifts of God for us, the people of God. Take them in remembrance that Christ has died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. Now let us pray together our act of reception prayer. In union, O Lord, with your faithful people at every altar of your church, where the Holy Eucharist is now being celebrated, I desire to offer to you praise and thanksgiving. I remember your death, Lord Christ. I proclaim your resurrection. I await your coming in glory. And since I cannot receive you today in the sacrament of your body and blood, I beseech you to come spiritually into my heart. Cleanse and strengthen me with your grace, Lord Jesus, and let me never be separated from you. May I live in you and you in me, in this life and in the life to come. Amen.
Trees clap their hands for you, oceans they dance for you.
prayer of thanksgiving is found on page 365. Let us pray together. Eternal God, Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace, and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart, through Christ our Lord. Amen. May Christ be with us, Christ within us, Christ behind us, Christ before us, Christ beside us, Christ to win us, Christ to comfort and restore us, Christ beneath and above us, Christ in quiet and in danger, Christ in hearts of all that love us, Christ in mouth of friend and stranger. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you now and evermore. Amen. Our closing hymn is hymn 367, verses 1, 2, and then 5. How firm a foundation. Stay safe out there.